Hello everyone.
In this video we are going to see interfacing of 4x4 keypad and LCD with PKTNF4520 microcontroller. This is also topic of unit number 5. Let's start it. See, this is how the interfacing of keypad and LCD is interfaced together with the PKTNF4520 microcontroller. We have already seen interfacing of LCD with PKTNF controller in previous video. If you haven't watched that video, I request you to watch that video first so that the logic of interfacing of LCD will be clear for you. Then it will be easy to understand this concept also. So when we are interfacing any keypad with your microcontroller, you always need one display device. This is your microcontroller, this is your keypad, then you will need one display device to display which key we are going to press or which key we are pressing. How to detect that is later part, but we need first some display device to display our output on it. So we are using LCD for that. So if you will watch that video, I don't need to explain that LCD part here in this video. That will be good if you watch that video prior to this video. Then start watching this. So how this keypad is interfaced? So actually this keypad is having 8 pins. How these 8 pins are available? See, there are 4 columns and there are 4 rows. How keys are used? So keys are over here like this. Right? If you are a third year student, then we have already seen the structure of this keypad in unit number 2 while interfacing with 8051 microcontroller, right? Right. See, so this is your keypad. So when these are crossing over here, these rows and columns are crossing each other, that doesn't mean it is connected over here. Where it will be connected, when this switch will be pressed, then the connection will take place over here. The connection will take place over here like that. Okay. So before that, no connection is present over here because these 2 points are open. This is not connected over here. So which 8 connections we have? We have 4 rows and we have these 4 columns. So these are those 8 connections. Here the space is very less to explain, so I will tell you over here directly. So these are the 4 rows and these are the 4 columns. And these 4 rows and 4 columns are combined together to get 16 cross points where these keys are situated. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, A, B, C, D, E, F. Right? And we are connecting this keypad to your microcontroller on port C. For data pins of this LCD, we are using port D. And for these RS, RW and enable, we are using RB3, RB4 and RB5. Over here. Right? Like this. Okay. So this is simple interfacing. The important part over here is the logic behind interfacing of keypad. So how do we do that? So for that, we need to make one algorithm. That algorithm is, first make all these 8 pins 0, like here, like this. So how can we do that? We need to just simply write port C is equal to, that's it, right? After that, make 2 sets of 4 pins, like either 4 columns and 4 rows. So this becomes one set and this becomes another. So out of these 2, you need to make one set as an input set and one set as an output set. Means either the data will be sent out from these 4 pins like this, and data will be sent in on these 4 pins, or you can do the vice versa also, like you can send over here and you can receive over here. So what I am doing in this case, I am going to make RC0, RC1, RC2 and RC3 input, and this will be output, and this will be output. After that, I will write 4 zeros over here and 4 zeros over here. This is initialization phase. We don't need to consider it any other way. This is initialization phase. After initialization, I will write once to all 4 rows, and I will write in columns, I will write like this. For column 1, this is C1, I will write 0, and for C2, C3 and C4, I will write 1, 1 and 1. Only C1 is 0, that means only here it is 0, otherwise these are 1s. So when it is 0, it is 0. When I am writing 0 to C1, I am considering only C1. I am not considering C2, C3 and C4 for this iteration. First iteration, this is first iteration. So when I am considering this iteration, then I am considering only these 4 pins, F, B, 7 and 3. I am not considering these remaining 12 pins. See, now the case is, I am considering only these 4 pins. I am not considering these. Okay, so I can drop this part. Now, see, key, when these all 4 pins are 1, and if it is 0, if any of these keys will be pressed, any of these keys will be pressed, then that respective pin will become 0. If F is pressed, that means this 0 will be sent from here to over here. If B is pressed, then it will be 0. Then if 7 is pressed, then it will be 0. If 3 is pressed, then it will be 0. So what I need to do, I just need to cross check or compare. I just need to cross check or compare these values of remaining 4 rows. If row 1 becomes 0, that means key F is pressed. If row 2 becomes 0, that means B is pressed. If row 3 becomes 0, then 7 is pressed. If row 4 becomes 0, then 3 is pressed, and then I will send accordingly the same signal to L3D also. So this is iteration 1. When I am considering iteration 2, these values will change. Now for iteration 2, this will become 1, this will become 0, 1 and 1, like this, 1, 0, 1, 1. Now I am considering iteration number 2, that means only this row. Now I am not considering this, not considering this, not considering this. I will again check for these all 4 rows. If this becomes 0, that means E is pressed. If this becomes 0, that means A is pressed. If this becomes 0, then 6. If this becomes 0, then it is 2. So similarly, I will do for iteration 3 and iteration 4. The same, only this 0 will be shifted to here for iteration 3, over here for iteration 4. Okay, if you don't understand this part, you can watch this part again. You will come to know what I want to say. Okay, so let's start with the program. This is configuration part only. This line is new, that is lcd.h. Why lcd.h? I am not going to write a program of LCD. I will write that program of LCD in this part, in this header file. I will store this header file in same folder and I will just call that header file, so that I don't need to write a program for LCD. Otherwise, this program will be too lengthy. Otherwise, this program will become too lengthy. So let's start. This is configuration part, and this I am calling this header file. Next part is, I am going to name these pins, like C0, C1, C2 and C3 will be called as R1, R2, R3 and R4. And remaining 4 will be called as C1, C2, C3 and C4 respectively. After that, I am taking 2 arrays with data type character. First array is having data SNJB COE. Second array is having data key pressed. How many digits are used? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 and 11. 11 alphabets are displayed on second character text. So what I'm going to do, I will call this first line on LCD line number 1, so it will be permanently displayed sngb COE, and on line number 2 I will display key pressed colon permanently. So whatever key will be pressed will be displayed after that on row number 2. How? Let's see. See, this is your main function. TrisD and TrisB are used for LCD. That is why I am making these two ports output ports. ADCON, you know, I am not using in any ADC. So all the pins in digital format. For that we write this value in ADCON 1. This is same value in every program. After that, as I told you, I will make two sets of these 8 pins. First 4 pins will be set to input, and these 4 will be set to output. After that, LCD init, this is function in lcd.h, then LCD display line number 1, LCD display line number 2. This is the same part that we have already seen in yesterday's program in previous video. You can check that video also. Okay. Now the while loop. See, for iteration number 1, I am making column number 1 0, remaining 3 columns are 1. If R1 means row 1 becomes 0, I will simply execute LCD dat routine with character F. If R2 is equal to 0, I will display B. If R3 is equal to 0, I will display 7. If R4 is equal to 0, I will display 3. F, B, 7, 3. How? F, B, 7, 3. Like I told you. Right? So similarly for iteration number 2, now I am making C2 is equal to 0 and C1, C3, C4 will become 1. Now the second iteration will check for EA6 2. Similarly, iteration number 3, iteration number 4. Okay, so this is how a 4x4 keypad is interfaced with the LCD. Thank you.